Hey Cody, Scott from Hey Guys. Nice to see you. Good to see you. Congratulations on the film.
Thank you very much.
It's a wonderful kind of epic story, but tell about your... Everyone loves him. Yeah, I don't know what it is. What is it? I don't get it.
English,
maybe it's an English thing.
No.
Tell about what drew you to your character, Peter, because you know you've played some amazing characters in your life, but what drew you to him and what was different for you with this role than anything you've played before?
I feel I love to take on challenges, but I feel this posed one of the biggest challenges I faced with character development and just trying to translate something from an amazing book, an amazing script, you know, into live action. And that was because the character is so internal in terms of how he thinks, how he ticks. And most part of the magic trick of playing him is to try and get the audience to constantly feel like, you know, they want to know what he's thinking. They want to know what his motivations are. So it's this kind of secret agent act of having to keep that all concealed, which I really love. I enjoyed it, and I feel with like the guidance of Jane, she really helped me bring that to its most potential.
And what's the lure of working with Jane for all of you guys in the ensemble? Because she has such a pull, and so many people seem to be... I think Benedict was just saying he was kind of nervous about working with her. Is that the same for you? And why do you think she has the pull of that kind of pull over people?
Well, she's just so unique in her presence, and an absolute masterful filmmaker, and... So I guess those are the nerves of excitement initially, just being in her presence. But to kind of feel the way she works and to feel the way she can poke and prod at you in the most healthiest way to challenge you to exit your comfort zone, to go beyond your boundaries as an actor, it's a real blessing. And sometimes it's uncomfortable, but you have to be in a space of being uncomfortable if you want to grow, if you want to evolve in anything that you're doing. So... to be able to do that in your craft with someone who's a master at that, I mean, it's a blessing.
And working with Benedict, obviously I know from speaking to him in the past that he goes quite deep into his characters, maybe not method per se, but he likes to get really involved in his characters. Yeah. How's that for you as an actor playing alongside that when he maybe doesn't quite be the Benedict that you know off screen?
Absolutely. I think it's cool. I think if anything, it has somewhat of like a domino effect on all of us. For Phil to kind of be present on set all the time and to have that almost hostile state around him, you know, it's all a part of the job, but it has a nice effect in which it keeps you in the mode, it keeps you in the vibe of the theme of this film and the momentum of it. I enjoyed it. It was good.
Just a final question. There's lots of talk in the Marvel Universe of multiverses. X-Men's maybe coming back. If they gave you a call about something to do with the X-Men Nightcrawler, would you be there?
Oh, if they gave me a call?
Yeah.
100% I'll be there. Yeah, dude, I would, you know, I take just as much enjoyment and things like that at the opposite side of the spectrum as I do, you know, a passion project like this. It's just a different form of expression that I try to dedicate myself to portray in the best way. So, yeah, I hope I get that call soon. But that multiverse seems like there's a good opportunity for that to happen. We'll see.
We'll see. I think Benedict knows a lot of secrets.
I know. Dude, I try to get it out of him. He's loyal to Marvel.
Well, that's our job. We're all trying.
I know.
Please, pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching... Hey, you guys!
Hey, you guys, huh?
Hey, you guys,
is that from the Goonies?
It is indeed, yes.
Nice.
Hey, you guys!